everyone.
Hi, sir. Good time to speak now?
Yes, good time to talk.
Great. So, we received an inquiry from a site for a property, sir, in Mulund. You were looking something for in Mulund?
I was looking at, someone mentioned this property to me, so I was looking at it.
Okay.
And I did some Google searches for site and I wanted to know more about it.
Sure, sir. I'll brief you about the entire development.
Sure.
To begin with, are you familiar with the location or shall I start with the location first?
Tell me everything. Cause,
perfect.
Let's start at the beginning.
Sure. So, with regards to location, sir, it is in Mulund West on the main LBS Marg itself. To be precise, it is exactly opposite to the Nirmal Lifestyle Mall, sir.
It is, okay. I've been to Nirmal Lifestyle.
Yeah, so it is exactly opposite to that. You are based out of Mulund itself, sir?
I'm in Borivali.
Borivali.
I had a friend who was living at Nirmal Lifestyle. Not at the mall, but there is a, I think there is a housing complex.
Yes, there is a residential development as well, just
a large
behind
residential
the
development,
mall.
Which is pretty old, as I remember visiting this person back in 2007-2008.
Correct. It's almost around 15 to 16 years old, that property. The Jin Nirmal Group have developed along with the mall.
Right.
Correct. So our property site is coming exactly opposite to that.
Okay.
And it is 11 acres of land bank which we are developing.
Okay.
So it will comprise of 5 towers of 57 story high.
Okay.
So the delivery timeline is expected by December 24.
Okay.
And currently the first tower has been launched in this development.
Got it. Okay.
Yes. So, we have options of 2, 3 and 3.5 BHK over here, sir. So, any specific requirement that you would be looking for?
I'm looking for a 3 BHK about 1050. That is basically what I've been looking for. 1050 square feet.
Correct.
Plus or minus some, but minus I would prefer not.
Sure.
Plus some if possible.
So, okay, perfect.
Yeah.
So, we do have options of carpet area, which might suit your requirements. So, there are basically 3 variations in 3 BHK.
Okay.
So, the minimum we have is of 904, but since you're looking for something which is a bit spacious, 904 would be out of question. Then, the next option that we have is of 1023, and the biggest that we have is of 1100, sir.
Yeah, well, 1100 should be good, or 1023 may also be considered.
Okay, fair enough. So, with regards to pricing of this each configuration, sir, these are the indicative pricing. Of course, when we meet, you like the property, everything is fine. We can offer a much better deal.
Yeah, there would be some negotiation, I'm sure.
Absolutely, sir. You don't need to worry about that. We'll definitely help you with a better deal. But just to give you an indicative idea, the pricing would be of 2.7 CR all inclusive. So, it would be ranging between 2.7 to 2.8 CR, a complete box price.
Does it have balconies or anything?
Yes, sir. It does have balconies, sir, in the living room. Correct.
That's good. Now, this is at launch stage or what is the, your delivery is it for, is it ready possession?
No, sir. It is currently at the launch stage. So, it will take 4 years to come up, as I mentioned earlier, sir. So, it will be delivered by December 24.
Okay. So, it is at launch stage.
At the launch stage, sir. So, you can see the excavation work has been done. We are going to put the plinth now.
Okay.
Correct.
Okay. So, 2024.
So this 2024. And moreover, we do have flexible payment options as well, which we are running through with. And moreover, if you have any payment plan that you would like to prefer, any kind of deviations that you require looking at the current scenario, we are open to have a chat for that.
What do you mean by flexible payment? What's the payment plan?
Normally, we follow a construction linked payment structure, sir. So, as the construction progresses, your milestones are due.
Okay.
But in the current scenario, sir, we are offering flexibility, as in you can pay a certain amount in the beginning. You can get a breather of around 18 months to 2 years.
So then your next certain amount would be what? You have to pay token and booking amount, is it? Booking amount is around 10%.
Around 10%. Mm-hmm. And the token amount would be of around 1 lakh rupees, sir.
Token is only 1 lakh?
Yeah, token is only 1 lakh.
Okay. And against the token, you would hold the inventory and for how long?
Against the token, sir, we can hold an inventory for you up till 2 months, sir.
Okay, so you can hold an inventory against a token for 2 months.
Yes, sir.
And at the end of it, I have to pay the remainder of the amount towards booking amount.
As the booking amount, yes.
Which
to
10%, which
to confirm your unit,
lakh,
basically.
So remaining,
yes.
26 lakh.
Correct.
Okay, let me just think this through.
But that is something which we can again discuss upon. So normally
I like to understand the financial,
sure,
part of it.
Sure.
So this token is refundable or non-refundable?
Token is refundable, sir.
So
it is absolutely refundable.
If after 2 months I have decided that I don't want to go ahead,
mm-hmm,
then you will give me back the token?
Yes, your money would be refunded, which we call these days as the expression of interest kind of a thing.
So it is expression of interest?
Yes.
Okay. Fine.
Correct.
So, fine. Okay, I understand. And your thing is, we enter into that after 2 months, I would have to be, it is Arya Par. Either I take back my expression of interest or I go,
uh-huh,
ahead and pay the rest of the booking amount.
Yes, to block an inventory, basically.
To block the inventory, to continue,
yes,
blocking the inventory.
To continue, yes, exactly. To confirm, basically, you can say.
To confirm, okay.
Yes.
So then we would have to enter into agreement also, right?
Yes. Then we get into the agreement. Yes.
Would have to happen once I have paid 10% of the booking amount.
Yes.
Okay. After that, rest of the payments, you are saying there will be a breather of 18 months, is it?
18 months to 2 years, sir. If you require something else, then we can discuss, have a chat for that as well. So normally, you give a breather of around 18 months. But on some special cases, an extension can be given of further 6 months, up till 2 years.
Okay, so 18 months to 2 years, we can get a breather on any payment and all payments.
So till then, there won't be any kind of EMIs if you're opting for a loan. No EMIs, no PMIs, nothing, absolutely nothing. So it's a kind of a holiday period.
Yeah, no EMIs because you're not looking at, okay, so you're not looking at a bank subvention, right? We are not,
okay,
looking.
No. We are not looking at the bank subvention
bank
or something.
Loan and loan.
Absolutely not.
To you or anything like that.
Nothing like that.
Looking at builder subvention, that is, it is, mm-hmm, not exactly a subvention, but okay. It's
a kind of a breather that we are providing from our side to the customers, you can say.
Okay.
A flexibility, we can say.
Okay. And of course, if I am not able to, then say according to the schedule.
Mm-hmm.
Construction linked schedule.
Construction linked schedule, yeah.
According to that schedule,
mm-hmm,
then there would be penal interest and all that would.
Yes. Then that bit kind of could get tedious, sir.
The schedule.
Nothing.
So the schedule has to be pretty strict from that point onwards.
Yes.
The schedule of payments become quite strict from that point onwards, depending on the construction and progress of the construction.
Yes, absolutely correct.
Okay. Theek hai. Just tell me more about the property. What is the thing? Is it a freehold land or what about the land?
It's a freehold land, sir. So your sales, marketing, construction, everything will be done by L&T itself.
Okay. And
with regards
to
amenities,
it's part of a bigger project or is it part of a larger layout or something like that?
No, sir. 11 acres is the entire land bank, sir.
11 acres is the land bank, which entirely is it this thing? It's, or is it part of another?
Yes, sir.
Because I'm aware of one project in Goregaon,
mm-hmm,
where people got a large land bank in an SRA. It was a large SRA project.
Okay.
And HDIL was supposed to build the rehab component.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't deliver the rehab component, but meanwhile sold rights to several builders. I think top 5-6 builders at least.
Okay.
And now those guys are stuck because HDIL has not completed the deal. And
got it.
MARA has to go and complete the rehab building.
Mm-hmm.
Because that is how the FSI was created.
Correct. True. Got your point, sir. But with regards to our land, sir, this is not the case. Because it's absolutely L&T entity that is going to, you are going to deal with. So everything will be transparent. So with regards to liquidity of cash, since our sister company is constructions and we do have our L&T finance, so the liquidity for us is not a crunch as of now. Because we have different sources within the organization itself to fund us, sir.
Okay.
So the construction delay should not be an issue. It would always bang on time, sir.
So this is not in any way linked to, it's not a larger, you know, there are no glitches here, is it?
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not, sir.
No possibilities of glitching?
Absolutely not.
And it's entirely, because I have faith in the L&T brand. But I'm not so sure when it comes to other these things, you know.
That's why, sir, we normally do not get into JVs or any kind of joint ventures, because we have to, end of the day, protect our own brand as well. Because as you mentioned, sir, once you get into that different kind of joint ventures, then there are a lot of legal procedures which you under need to go through, and then there is a lot of hassle. So we avoid, normally avoid that, and we do not get into that. So we purchase a land piece, we develop it, we sell it, and we get rid of it. So that's how our business policy is. We normally do not get into any kind of joint ventures or any kind of stuff.
Okay, that is really good.
Correct.
I appreciate that.
Yes. Correct. Yeah. So what I can suggest is that if you're comfortable enough to travel down all the way from Borivali to Mulund, we can show you the place, we'll be more than happy. Or considering the current scenario, we can offer you a virtual site tour as well. So whatever suits you first. To get a comprehensive
Can you send me your UOI form? Let me take a look at it, terms and conditions and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So let me look at the financial part of it.
Sure.
And apply my mind to that.
Sure.
So, you know, it clearly says how much UOI I have to give and all that, right?
UOI forms are basically, it is a normal expression of interest form. So when you just give your preference, your flow bands, what exactly you would be looking for, what kind of apartment, what configuration you would be looking for, what are the flow bands, and you can give us your preference and a token of 1 lakh rupees, based on which we can block an inventory of your choice.
So can you just tell me that? Let me take a look at it.
Sure. Definitely, sir. I can do that.
Okay. And tell me the RERA number.
RERA number, sure sir. If you want, I can WhatsApp you all the details, sir. So you can go through the details.
WhatsApp me all the details and give me a call tomorrow morning, or let me just check on RERA. Give me a call tomorrow afternoon.
Sure.
Okay. Send me all the details and let me look at this thing.
Absolutely.
Maybe tomorrow. You guys are available in the later evening?
We are available in
5:36
should be fine with us, sir. Absolutely. We are available. So we'll send you the details straight away. You can do your basic research, sir.
Theek hai. Do send
me. And then we shall connect.
Okay, good. Send me.
Okay. I will do that, sir.
Sure. Thanks so much. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye-bye. Hello.
Yeah, Devansh, you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yeah, please tell me.
Okay. You are, by the way, you are not channel partner, right? You are...
No, absolutely not, sir. If you want, I can drop you a mail as well.
Right.
In fact, suggest avoid any kind of channel partner or brokers in between.
Yeah, so you are directly L&T Asian.
Yes,
Realty.
Sir.
Yeah. Oh,
yes,
okay.
Yes, sir. I'm an L&T employee.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the name of this project, let me see, it is the Rejuve 360 Tower A. That is what RERA is saying.
Yes, correct.
So we are talking about the same property, Rejuve 360 Tower A.
Same property, absolutely correct.
Okay.
Tower A, the first tower.
Right. Okay. But you said there is no joint venture, right?
Correct.
Well,
you can see Nirmal as a joining landholding partner, sir, but
it is a joint venture. It is a joint venture where Nirmal Lifestyle and L&T. So I asked you about the land and you know, whether it is freehold or not.
Correct.
And you told me, and I mean, the Nirmal Lifestyle is a joint venture partner. It is the owner of the land.
I will explain you, sir, how does it work. So what exactly it is that we prior to us, Nirmal was the owner of the land.
Prior right? to you, so, Nirmal was the owner of the land.
Yeah, Nirmal was the owner of the land, and okay. we have got into them with an agreement where we have reserved all the rights of sales, marketing, and construction. Everything will be done from us.
Okay.
So there is absolutely nothing when you will be dealing with Nirmal, sir. You will be purely dealing with L&T as well. And if you want any further legal documents as well, we are open to share that as well. You can have a read or have a look at that.
No, that is fine. We will not be dealing with Nirmal, but mm-hmm. Nirmal is the owner of the land.
Mm-hmm.
And you are in joint venture with Nirmal. This it looks like a joint venture agreement where there is a promoter one, promoter two. Where Nirmal is promoter number two and you are promoter number one. And so my agreement of sale is with both of you. See, agreement of sale is not mm-hmm. only with you. My agreement of
Your agreement will be purely done with us, sir.
No, look at so it. It says agreement for sale and it mm-hmm. is saying that agreement for sale is with both of you. So, L&T Asian Realty LLP and Nirmal mm-hmm. Lifestyle Developers Private Limited, and then mm-hmm. there is the space for myself, that is the allottee.
Correct, absolutely correct.
So my agreement of sale is with both of you.
Your agreement of sale, sir, how does it work is that they are just be namesakes, sir. Apart from that, there is nothing else where the Nirmal would be involved.
They are just namesake, is it?
Yes, absolutely, sir. Apart from that, nothing, I mean, you will not see any marketing, you will not see anything which is done on behalf of Nirmal, sir, for this particular project. We'll be completely dealing with L&T.
I understand that you guys are at the front end.
Correct.
Okay, you guys are at the front end, but then Nirmal mm-hmm. is very much under the bonnet.
No,
it's like the
not.
Top of a car, inside the, you open the bonnet and then you have Nirmal. Okay.
No, sir.
More importantly, yeah. I am seeing another one, the layout approval. So,
yes.
Would you like to tell me whether you are the building proposal has been put up by you or building proposal has been put up by Nirmal?
It has been put up by us, sir.
No. It says here, building proposal, name of the owner. It says mm-hmm. here, Nirmal, Sri Dharmesh Jain, director, Methods Nirmal Lifestyle Private Limited. So, it is very much Nirmal.
No, sir. How does it work is that in that 11 acres, they have a separate land bank over there, which is for their commercial use.
Okay.
So, which further down the line, after 4 years, when it's complete the residential part, we'll be taking up the commercials from them as well. So, there is a construction, semi-construction is standing over there, which was done by Nirmal. So, that has halted. So, which we are going to develop in future as a commercial complex. Apart from that, the 11 acres which is purely for residential, the entire layout is put up by us. I can share the master layout as well from our side.
But as far as BMC is concerned, it is Nirmal everywhere. See, another one I'm seeing, specific to the building. So I was looking at the mm-hmm. layout approval, now I'm looking at the building approval.
Okay,
amended plan approval letter, this is on the BMC letterhead. And this is building proposal department file dated, amendment dated 18th October 2019. So, almost exactly
correct.
1 year ago. Okay.
Correct.
So, and it is addressed also to Manoj Valjibhai Daisaria, Nirmal Lifestyle Limited. Proposed residential building wing ABCD. Some commercial wing E. Building number 3 on plus. So, I believe we are talking about the same project. This is from the same thing. So
yes,
basically,
sir.
So, when you are saying that it is only L&T, on the contrary, you guys seem to be marketing something that is basically Nirmal here. It is being built by Nirmal. I don't know whether they have contracted it to you or what it is. But from all appearances, it looks like, as far as BMC is concerned, it's Nirmal. So, what I'm trying to say is, if there are non-compliances,
correct.
Whether it is your non-compliance or Nirmal's non-compliance, BMC is going to go after Nirmal.
No, sir. You will not be going after Nirmal. So, we have a documented place where we have almost spent around like 50 crores, where we have the power of attorney with us, sir. So wherein you will not be dealing with Nirmal anyway. And if in future, if there is any kind of mishap, so any kind of misunderstanding, so miscommunication from either of the sides, we have the power to take over the entire land parcels with us.
Do you have any paperwork to that effect?
Yes, sir. We do have that paperwork.
Send it to me. Let me take a look at it.
Sure. We have done the legal document as well. I will do that.
You should have told me about this now because... I mean, CC is in the in favor of Nirmal. Commencement certificate, Dharmesh Jain, CA2 owner. This is also in favor of Nirmal only.
So I will share the legal documents.
You should have at least told me here that this is a JV. Because when
it's not exactly LNT a JV.
LNT, but then Nirmal is, Nirmal is Nirmal. And
true,
everybody...
I do understand your concern, sir. Huh? Any genuine customer would have that. I'm not denying your concern. Right. 110% correct, sir. I'm not denying that. But to explain,
the sound around Nirmal in the market is not a very good sound.
Absolutely not, sir. We will not promote anyone to Nirmal. To be honest, on personal terms, if you ask me that if I would like to purchase a flat, I will never go with Nirmal.
Yeah.
That's the honest feedback which I'm giving.
Correct. But so that is what I'm seeing. I'm seeing Nirmal, as far as BMC is concerned, it's all Nirmal. So the permissions are given to Nirmal. Everything seems to be in Nirmal's name, basically. It's not just the land. It's not like you are building on Nirmal's land. You are kind of building Nirmal's project for all practical purposes. That is what it looks like.
It looks only prima facie, it looks like that. But it's not the actual case. So what I will do is that tomorrow, first thing in the morning, sir, if you want, I can ask one of my legal team to get in touch with you, along with me, on the call, and we can explain everything.
Now do one thing. Yeah. Send me the paperwork that shows me that I'll be dealing in terms of any deficiencies. Mm. I will be dealing with LNT and not with Nirmal. Just send me the paperwork. I don't want to
I will do that first thing in the morning.
Arguing and discussing this thing.
True.
Okay.
Fair enough, sir. So tomorrow, first thing in the morning, I will send you the legal documents. You can read it. If everything satisfies you, only then you can take the conversation, right?
Sure. Okay. Thanks a ton.
All right.
Bye.
Yeah. Thank you. Bye.
Yes. Hi, Krishnaraj.
Hello. Yeah, Mr. Krishnaraj, a very good evening. Shefali this side. I am calling with regards to LNT Realty. I'll take an inquiry.
LNT 360, right? Residuate 360.
Right,
Shefali. Tell me. Yesterday I talked with Devansh. So did Devansh? Did Devansh refer you?
You have put your name, number and email address.
Okay. So you are coming directly from this thing. Okay. So there is a guy named Devansh who also talked with me yesterday.
Okay.
About this. Okay. So tell me, Ridgeway 360.
Yeah, right. So tell me, sir, what exactly your requirement is?
3 BHK, about more than 1050 carpet. I believe you have that configuration. I'm not sure.
We can do
Jodi of 2 BHK also, if that is
Jodi
possible.
Option is not available, sir.
Okay, Jodi option is not available, but there is a 3 BHK more than 1050.
Yeah, we have 1024 square feet carpet, then we have 1080 square feet carpet, then we have 1300 square feet carpet also available.
Okay, 1080, what is the rate for that?
It's starting from 2.95 crore.
2.95 crore. Okay.
And 2.95 includes your stamp duty, registration, car parking, GST, everything.
Okay. Achha, by the way, I hope this is not the same as 2019 or January 2020 prices. I hope there has been a reduction because I am looking for properties where price correction has already happened.
So आप लॉन्च के टाइम पे भी आई थे क्या साइड पे?
नहीं, लॉन्च पे नहीं आया था मैं. लॉन्च पे बात जरूर हुई थी, लॉन्च पे आया नहीं था. आई थिंक यू लॉन्च समटाइम इन जनवरी, इज इट?
No, so not exactly in January. UI process was being started for this property.
UI की बात करी थी. Somebody had a discussion with me. Couple of people had a discussion with me about UI back then. Someone sent me an UI form also. I don't know if the same form is valid now or whether the form has changed.
Sir, the EUI process is not valid now. Right now, what we are doing, if the customer, the booking process has been opened.
EUI process is no longer valid.
We don't have EUI process available.
Okay, no, because yesterday only this guy whom I spoke to, he sent me an EUI form as well. I was also saying, boss, same thing.
January mein
jab EUI chalu tha, So मेरा December शायद I think I must have had a chat with somebody in December 2019 or thereabouts. I think either end of last year or beginning of this year, there was a conversation that I remember with Reju Ethnicity. And at that time UI was on. I said, अभी भी UI चालू है. I mean, obviously there has to be a date for opening the UI, na? Ending the end of the UI process is when the launch happens.
अभी एक्चुअली प्रोसेस ऐसा चालू है ना सर, बिकॉज ऑफ लॉकडाउन एक रिफंडेबल पे हम 1 लाख का स्वाइप ले रहे हैं. इफ इन कोई कस्टमर है जो श्योर नहीं होते हैं,
ओके या गो ऑन.
हाँ, इफ इन कोई कस्टमर यूनिट शॉर्टलिस्ट कर रहा है ना सर, तो जिस यूनिट अगर उनको होल्ड करना है ताकि उनको क्लैरिटी मिले, तब तक के लिए हम एक 1 लाख का रिफंडेबल प्रोसेस पे स्वाइप ले रहे हैं. तो जैसे ही वो पूरे शो जाते हैं तो वो बाकी का पेमेंट कर सकते हैं आके.
से अगेन, रिफंडेबल पे स्वाइप ले रहे हैं? नहीं नहीं, आई डिडंट अंडरस्टैंड, आई एम सो सॉरी, से प्लीज रिपीट.
रिफंडेबल पे मींस इफ इन केस अगर कस्टमर ने जैसे बोला अभी यूनिट शॉर्टलिस्ट करके उन्होंने होल्ड किया, 1 लाख का अमाउंट दे दिया, ठीक है, और उन्होंने बोला कि दे विल रिवर्ट बैक इन 2 डेज, तो वो 2 दिन के लिए हम उनको वो रिफंडेबल का.
अच्छा, दैट इज यूआई इज ओनली फॉर होल्डिंग द यूनिट for couple of
right.
days.
Right.
हाँ, okay, understood.
Right. उसके बाद अगर कस्टमर 2 दिन के बाद, जैसे मतलब 2 दिन के अंदर ही उनको अपना डिसीजन बताना होता है सर, और अगर उन्होंने बोला कि नहीं हो पा रहा है कुछ भी फाइनेंशियली या फिर कुछ भी रीजन की वजह से, या फिर यूनिट लाइन कुछ पसंद नहीं आया उनको वैसा करके, तो फिर हम लोग फिर अमाउंट जो है वो रिफंडेबल.
नहीं, लेकिन 2 दिन में नहीं बताया, समझो कि डिस्कशन करते करते हफ्ता 2 हफ्ता लग गया, बीच आए सीन वेरी इजिली हैपन प्रॉपर्टी.
एक वीक का सर एक्सटेंशन प्रोवाइड किया जा सकता है, वो तो
उसके बाद आप बाई डिफॉल्ट रिफंड कर दोगे या बाई डिफॉल्ट आप फॉरफिट कर लोगे?
नहीं सर, आपसे बात करने के बाद, कस्टमर से बात करने के बाद, क्लैरिफिकेशन लेने के बाद हम उनको पहले ही बोल देते हैं तो क्या करना है बताइए, या तो आप बताइए, अगर यूनिट कैंसिल करना है तो कैंसिल कर देते हैं.
नहीं, मेरा
तो अगर आपको आगे,
माय पॉइंट इज अबाउट द मनी. सपोज यूनिट मैंने, आई सॉ विद माय फैमिली लेट अस से दिस वीकेंड, वैसे हर एक वीकेंड में मेरा कुछ ना कुछ कहीं ना कहीं एक आध सा साइट विजिट तो होता ही है, ठीक है. तो ये वीकेंड में सपोज आई कम टू योर साइट एंड आई सी द प्रॉपर्टी, ओके, एंड माय वाइफ सेज ओके लेट अस थिंक अबाउट इट एंड ऑल दैट डिस्कस एंड आई टेल यू 1 वीक. अब आजकल का मॉडर्न लाइफ ऐसा है कि 1 वीक में भी डिस्कशन नहीं हो पाता है. ऐसे मैंने कई सारे वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चीजें हैं, लेकिन एवरीबडी इज इन्वॉल्व इन अ लाइफ ऑफ देयर ओन. माय वाइफ ऑल्सो, माय सन ऑल्सो, इवन इन लॉकडाउन हमको एक दूसरे का अपॉइंटमेंट लेना पड़ता है टाइम बात करने के लिए. दिस इज क्वाइट नॉर्मल, आई अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम एवरीबडीज एक्सपीरियंस कि आजकल ऐसे हो रहा है. नाउ माय क्वेश्चन टू यू इज, सपोज मैंने आपसे 1 वीक बोला और 1 वीक के 2 वीक या 3 वीक हो गए, मेरा सवाल अब आपसे ये है, मेरा जो एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट बाय डिफॉल्ट आप
कैंसिल हो जाएगा,
मतलब मुझे रिफंड दे दोगे,
अमाउंट रिफंड मिल जाएगा,
अमाउंट रिफंड मिल जाएगा. यू विल से सर सॉरी, आपने बोला था 1 वीक हमने होल्ड किया है, 10 दिन हो गए,
यूनिट रिलीज कर दिया करके,
हमने यूनिट रिलीज कर दिया और आपका अमाउंट जो है वो रिफंड हो जाएगा. दिस इज हाउ यू डील विथ ईओआई. ओके, मतलब ईओआई जब से नहीं होता है ना, ये डज नॉट बिकम फॉरफिटेड. ऐसे नहीं है कि सर अब आपको ईओआई का अमाउंट नहीं मिलेगा बिकॉज वी हैंड इट फॉर 1 वीक.
अगर कंपनी ने सर रिफंडेबल क्लॉज दिया है तो फिर अमाउंट फॉरफिट नहीं होगा सर.
नहीं, अगर 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 दिया है तो ये अगर इज,
अगर आपकी डिस्कशन में रिफंडेबल का बात ही नहीं हुआ है, अगर आपने बोला कि दैट आपको कैंसिल ही नहीं करना है यूनिट, बस आपको सेकेंड पेमेंट के लिए जो टाइम पीरियड प्रोवाइड चाहिए होगा तो फिर वो हम लोग टाइम डिविजन प्रोवाइड करते हैं.
बट इफ अगर दैट इज टोकन, दैट इज नॉट ईओआई.
वही डेफिनेटली, तो अगर आप पूरा टोकन अमाउंट दे रहे हो, टोकन हमारा सर 5 लाख का है ना.
ओके, टोकन अमाउंट इज 5 लाख. तो अगर 5 लाख दे दिया है तो समझो टोकन हो गया, टोकन हो गया तो यूनिट बुक हुआ. और फिर अगर मैंने सेकेंड पेमेंट नहीं किया तो वो रिफंड नहीं होगा, वो फॉरफिट.
नहीं, वो रिफंड नहीं होगा, वो फॉरफिट होगा. यस,
बट उसके लिए ऑफकोर्स पूरा पेपर वर्क अलग रहता होगा ना. यानी
वो तो व्हाट आई राइट, मतलब वो तो ऐसा नहीं है कि अगर आपने अगर किसी कस्टमर का पेमेंट नहीं आया तो हम डायरेक्टली कैंसिल कर देंगे यूनिट या प्रॉफिट कर देंगे. हम सर मैनेजमेंट से बात करके टाइम डिविजन भी प्रोवाइड करते हैं.
हाँ ठीक है, लेकिन इन दी एंड अगर टाइम में भी नहीं हो पाया, समटाइम्स इट हैपेंस लाइक दिस कि फंड, मैं सोचता हूँ कि अरे इतने टाइम में फंड रिलीज हो जाएगा, लेकिन सोचते हैं और एक्चुअली होने में फर्क होता है. तो कभी कभी ऐसे हो जाता है,
होता है. और आपको जैसे कि अगर अभी पॉसिबल ही नहीं हो पा रहा है आगे बढ़ना, तो फिर क्या क्लाइंट्स खुद ही कैंसिलेशन का मेल डाल देते हैं. और वो अमाउंट तो सर प्रॉफिट होता ही है सर. अब वो कितने परसेंटेज पे होता है, पूरा होता है या नहीं होता है, उसका जो डिटेल वो हमारे पोस्टल के पास है.
वो आपके,
वो एग्जैक्टली मुझे भी नहीं पता है अमाउंट कितना प्रॉफिट होता है.
ये थोड़ा सा आपको पता होना चाहिए बिकॉज यू आर सेलिंग ना. तो इसमें क्या होता है, ऑफकोर्स आप तो सिर्फ यही कह रहे हो कि साइट पे आ जाओ, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू बी.
नहीं, सेल कर रही हूँ, राइट. आई एम जस्ट इन्वाइटिंग यू एट द साइट ऑफिस, जहाँ पे प्रोडक्ट मैनेजर है वो प्रॉपर्टी सेल करेंगे. ठीक है, माई वर्क इज टू कॉल द कस्टमर एट साइट.
ऑल राइट, चलो टेल मी अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टी, टेल मी अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टी, लेट मी जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टी.
ओके, सो आपका जो देवान से बात हुआ था, सो आई वॉन्ट यू नो वो डायरेक्टली L&T के मैनेजर है या फिर आपका.
He told me he was direct from L&T. You are not direct from L&T?
सर आई एम, दैट्स व्हाई मैंने आपको बोला ना कि आपका
ही आल्सो सेड, वही मैं कह रहा हूँ, देवांश सेड ही इज डायरेक्ट फ्रॉम एलएनटी.
उन्होंने, मैंने ऐसे पूछा आपको कि उन्होंने फिर क्या क्या इन्फॉर्मेशन प्रोवाइड की है.
ओके, सो ही टोल्ड मी दिस इज अपोजिट निर्मल लाइफस्टाइल मॉल. ही टोल्ड मी दैट दिस इज इट इज फ्री होल्ड लैंड, 11 acres.
नो सर, इट्स नॉट अ फ्री होल्ड लैंड. मैं आपको इस पे एक क्लैरिफिकेशन प्रोवाइड करती हूँ. लैंड जो है वो JV में है विद निर्मल लाइफस्टाइल.
इट इज इन जॉइंट वेंचर विद निर्मल लाइफस्टाइल.
हाँ, लेकिन पूरा कंस्ट्रक्शन का, बिल्डिंग का, डेवलपमेंट का वगैरह पूरा L&T ही कर रहा है, L&T कंस्ट्रक्ट कर रहा है. निर्मल का सिर्फ उनका लैंड पार्सल उनके नाम पे है, दैट्स इट. सो ही इज लाइक अ स्लीपिंग पार्टनर.
बट आगे का पार्टनर कौन है, पीछे का पार्टनर कौन है? यू आर टेलिंग मी दैट L&T इज मार्केटिंग फॉर निर्मल लाइफस्टाइल.
नो, नॉट एग्जैक्टली मार्केटिंग. जो प्रॉपर्टी कंस्ट्रक्ट हो रहा है ना, वो भी पूरा L&T ही कर रहा है. L&T के नाम पे ही है
कंस्ट्रक्शन. मतलब आप, यू आर कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स फॉर, बिकॉज आई नो L&T डज अ लॉट ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स.
में है सर, जॉइंट वेंचर में है. लैंड पार्सल जो है वो जॉइंट वेंचर में है.
ओके,
निर्मल के साथ.
ठीक है, बिल्डिंग परमिशंस किसके नाम पे है?
L&T के. बिल्डिंग के, लैंड के परमिशन की बात कर रहे हो आप?
नहीं नहीं, BMC में आपने IODCC किससे लिया है? आपने लिया है या ये निर्मल ने लिया है?
नहीं, निर्मल ने नहीं लिया सर, L&T ने लिया है.
और लेआउट जो है, लेआउट प्लान वगैरह जो भी है, 11 acre इज नॉट आपका एक सिर्फ टावर ए, यू आर ओनली डेवलपिंग टावर ए.
हमारा 7 acre में रेजिडेंशियल है, 11 acre का पूरा लैंड पार्सल है. बट जो प्रॉपर्टी का जो कंस्ट्रक्शन हो रहा है ना, वो सिर्फ 7 acres में हो रहा है.
7 acres में,
बाकी का जो 4 acres है ना, वहाँ पे BMC गार्डन बन रहा है.
ठीक है, और उसके अंदर रेजिडेंशियल एंड कमर्शियल दोनों हो रहा है, करेक्ट?
कमर्शियल का सर अब तक हमें कुछ मैनेजमेंट से नहीं मिला इन्फो. अभी तो सर रेजिडेंशियल ही प्लान आउट हुआ है, उसमें भी आप रेरा में देखेंगे तो आपको शो करेगा कि आगे जो है वो 4 towers का प्लान है. अभी के लिए सिर्फ हमने Tower 1 ही ओपन किया है.
टावर ए आई थिंक ही टोल्ड मी.
या Tower 1 ही अभी अब तक ओपन किया है.
राइट, राइट.
तो Tower 1 का एलिवेशन ऐसा है कि पहले 3 levels के बेसमेंट कार पार्क है, फिर ग्राउंड प्लस 7 levels का पोडियम कार पार्क है. देन 7 के ऊपर 3 levels पे हमारे एमिनिटीज रहेंगे. तो जो फर्स्ट हैबिटेबल फ्लोर है वो 11th floor से स्टार्ट हो रहा है.
ओके,
तो वहां से 57 हैबिटेबल फ्लोर होगा, जिसमें से अभी बुकिंग के लिए 45th floor तक का अप्रूवल मिला है हमें सेल आउट के लिए.
ओके ओके. सो कल जो देवान से बात हो रही थी, ही वॉज टेलिंग मी दैट, होल्ड ऑन, या देवान से तो जो बात हो रही थी, ही वॉज टेलिंग मी दैट एलएनटी इज द प्राइमरी. एक्चुअली इट वॉज, ही डिडंट टेल मी जेवी, हम जेवी नहीं करते सर वगैरह वगैरह, वी आर आवर सेल्फ.
मुझे एक्चुअली पता नहीं देवांश भी एग्जैक्टली कौन है.
हाँ, नाउ आई वंडर, मैं भी सोच रहा हूँ कि इजी फ्रॉम एलएनटी और इजी आल्सो चैनल पार्टनर और समथिंग लाइक दैट पॉसिबल. मैं आपको नंबर शेयर कर सकता हूँ, आई कैन शेयर योर कॉन्टैक्ट.
हाँ, आप मुझे नंबर शेयर कर लीजिए, मैं फिर अपने सिस्टम में चेक करके बता सकती हूँ कि डायरेक्टली है या फिर कोई थर्ड पार्टी का भी अगर होता है तो शो कर देता है हमें.
करेक्ट, हु थर्ड पार्टी हु इज क्लेमिंग टू बी पार्ट ऑफ एलएनटी, हो सकता है, इट इज पॉसिबल.
ओके,
सो यू आर
एग्जैक्टली कहाँ रहते हैं आप? मलन के
बोरीवली रहेजा? नहीं, बोरीवली रहेजा. माय डॉटर इज प्लानिंग टू मूव टू दैट साइड, शी इज लुकिंग फॉर प्रॉपर्टीज इन दैट साइड. शी वॉज ऑफकोर्स थिंकिंग थाने, बट आई सेड थाने से बेहतर होगा मुलुंड. It is better to be more inside the city.
Okay, so आप basically क्या budget range में देख रहे हो sir property?
See, budget is not an issue because I have closed down my business recently. So budget का मेरे पास वैसे बहुत बड़ा constraint नहीं है. I am even looking at properties. I know your property is not that expensive, but I am even looking at properties which are more expensive. Shape Beaumont वगैरह देख रहा हूँ, 5.5 crore वगैरह. So
okay,
we are discussing those properties. It's another story के फाइनलाइज करेंगे नहीं करेंगे. सो बजट इज नॉट अ कंस्ट्रेंट, बजट इज अ कंसिडरेशन बट नॉट अ कंस्ट्रेंट.
अंडरस्टूड.
ओके, इट इज ऑफकोर्स अ कंसिडरेशन. मैं डेफिनेटली कॉस्ट बेनिफिट रेशियो तो देखूंगा ही देखूंगा, उसमें कहीं दो बात नहीं है. बट इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी द सीलिंग लाइक, अरे बॉस इससे आगे नहीं बढ़ सकते, इससे आगे बढ़ेंगे तो हो ही नहीं सकता है. दैट इज नॉट एन इश्यू, बट आई एम लुकिंग एट द बेस्ट वैल्यू फॉर माई मनी. नाउ सिंपल क्वेश्चन इज, तो आपका तो ऑफकोर्स वैल्यू प्रोपोजिशन बहुत अच्छा है कम्पेयर टू सेठ ब्यूमोंट, एंड एलबीएस मार्ग इज अ गुड लोकेशन, एंड निर्मल लाइफ स्टाइल इज अ गुड लोकेशन. ओके, हालांकि निर्मल द बिल्डर इज नॉट सच अ, ही हैज रन इन टू सम अमाउंट ऑफ ट्रबल, सो हैविंग हिम एज योर ज्वाइंट वेंचर पार्टनर डज पुट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ क्वेश्चन मार्क. और एक बात मैं आपको बता दूं कि मैंने कल रेरा चेक किया था, क्योंकि मैंने आप उनसे पूछा, I asked him for the RERA number. He sent me expression of interest form, and I checked the RERA, this thing of L&T Ridgeway Tower A. Now, from what I understand, and I read all the MOUs, I read the agreement format, etc. So, I saw the MOU between L&T Realty, Asian Realty, and Linval Lifestyles. But it is of concern that BMC से जो भी परमिशंस लिए हैं, वो सारे जो परमिशंस हैं वो शेत के नाम पे हैं. आई एम सॉरी, व्हाट आई एम थिंकिंग, शेत वो इसके नाम पे है, निर्मल के नाम पे. वो सारे निर्मल के नाम पे हैं. ओके, सो एज फार एज BMC इज कंसर्नड, यू आर नॉट इन द पिक्चर, L&T इज नॉट इन द पिक्चर, दैट इज अ फैक्ट. और आप लोगों का जो है, इट इज रेवेन्यू शेयरिंग अरेंजमेंट. आई डोंट नो वॉट रेवेन्यू शेयरिंग एग्जैक्टली इज, बट यू हैव सम काइंड ऑफ रेवेन्यू शेयरिंग अरेंजमेंट विथ निर्मल. लेकिन निर्मल इज वेरी लार्ज, इट इज नॉट नहीं सिर्फ लैंड ओनर है, ऐसे नहीं है. लैंड ओनर होते हुए ही इज ऑल्सो द, एज फार एज BMC इज कंसर्न, यू आर नोवेयर इन द पिक्चर. L&T इज नोवेयर इन द पिक्चर. सारे IOD, CC जो भी है, और वो सारे जो हैं 2019 में इश्यू किए गए हैं. सो बिल्डिंग परमिशन सारे के सारे निर्मल के नाम पे. तो इट इज अ बिट लाइक यू आर द कार, कार का ब्रांड L&T है, बट बॉनेट ओपन करोगे तो सारे पार्ट्स आपको निर्मल के मिलते हैं. दैट इज द क्वेश्चन मार्क. BMC विल से द ऑपोजिट थिंग. आई एम सेइंग फ्रॉम द कस्टमर साइड, that car is of L&T and under the bonnet everything is Nirmal. BMC will say car is of Nirmal and under the bonnet it is L&T, because from their point of view they'll say kaun hai L&T Realty, wo batayenge nahi, wo khada hi nahi karenge. They'll say site Nirmal ka hai. Matlab now the issue arises here as a customer. If any compliances are not met, okay, from any side. And compliances, matlab, so many compliances are there. I don't even want to get into it. For example, recreation ground, kam pada, amount of, you know, the space that you have occupied is too much. Fire brigade ka compliance nahi milta hai, open space requirement nahi hota hai, any compliance, okay. If any compliance is not met, they will shut down. They will shut down this thing, or they will say, they will slap notices on Nirmal, not on you. From a customer side, I am signing a tripartite agreement. I am signing an agreement with you, and I am signing an agreement with Nirmal. I am happy to sign an agreement with L&T. I am not so happy to sign an agreement with Nirmal, and if it is Nirmal, then I am not very happy. So that is definitely an issue. That's definitely an issue.
Okay. So, yeah. Are you also itself a builder?
Am I also?
I'm also itself a builder because you have so much knowledge about it.
Yeah. I am not a builder, but I have knowledge of real estate. I have been associated with real estate industry. I have been advisor and consultant to many people. I give legal advice to many people. So, and I was closely associated with the framing of RERA before RERA was formed, as early as 2012. I was associated with, I have understood the law that was the progenitor, yani uska pehle ka. Before the RERA Act came in, there was another law which was very similar to RERA, which was being considered back in 2011-12. So, kaafi public debate uspe hua tha, tabhi I was very much part of that.
Okay.
So it is like that.
Understood. So then, sir, आप कब site visit के लिए आ सकते हैं?
I'll see this weekend. I'll see this weekend. लेकिन ये सारे मेरे reservations हैं थोड़े. And
understood, sir. But एक बार अगर आप site पे आएंगे ना, एक product manager से बात करेंगे, तो वो एक point of view अपना भी रख पाएंगे product को लेके, क्योंकि definitely management से जितनी information उन्हें मिलती है, वो हमसे कहीं ज़्यादा है.
See, I usually look for that information up front. मुझे ये साइट पे जाना और फिर वो इन्फॉर्मेशन मिलना बहुत ज्यादा पसंद नहीं है. ट्रांसपेरेंसी एक ऐसी चीज है, दैट इज द ग्रेट थिंग अबाउट RERA, कि RERA में सब कुछ अपलोड करते हैं और करना पड़ता है. सो दैट इज वेरी गुड, दैट्स एक्चुअली वेरी गुड. यू नो, लॉट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन इज ऑलरेडी ऑन RERA साइट, एंड दैट इज वेरी गुड.
राइट.
नॉट सो मच इन्फॉर्मेशन इज डिस्क्लोज्ड by sellers, and that is not very good, because often what happens is mis-selling ho jata hai iske karan. Aur expression of interest solicit kiya jata hai, to expression of interest is sort of mera paisa aapke garage mein impounded hai, ya meri gaadi aapke garage mein impounded hai, aisa ek arrangement hai. To EOI agar kar rahe hain, to EOI ke jo terms and conditions hain, there are absolutely no benefits promised to the customer at all. मैं क्यों भी impound करूंगा? Because obviously January में हम EOI की बात कर रहे थे और अब October में पहुंच गए हैं. Okay, तो 8 महीने हो गए ना? नहीं, 10 महीने हो गए. तो 10 महीने में भी अगर EOI ही मिल रहा है, मतलब availability of flats कहीं नहीं जा रहा है. You don't have to hold a property for me. वो होल्डिंग वाली जो बात है, वी आर होल्डिंग द इन्वेंट्री फॉर यू, वो सॉरी टू से झूठा साबित होता है. होल्डिंग की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. देयर इज नो डर्थ ऑफ इन्वेंट्री, है इन्वेंट्री, सरप्लस है, डर्थ नहीं है ना. तो ये होल्डिंग करके वो फिर टोकन लेके फिर टोकन जब्त करना वगैरह, थोड़ा इट्स नॉट अ वेरी गुड प्रैक्टिस. नॉट योर फॉल्ट. It is how the real estate market is, but it's not a good practice.
Okay.
Then
I'll call you back tomorrow, sir. Let me know our weekend.
Yeah, you do one thing. Yeah, yeah. I'll plan for weekend. You do one thing. You send me you take my WhatsApp number. Send me hi on WhatsApp. I will share this Devansh's number with you, and let me know whether he is. Okay, tell me whether he is, because he claimed that he was employee. He claimed he was employee of L&T. So you just confirm or say, tell me he is not. You know, he is only channel partner. Itna bata do. I'll share you the contact and you take a look.
Okay, fine. So
कम से कम इतना तो आपको होना चाहिए कि if somebody is claiming things which are about you, but he is not completely associated with you, so far. Or if he is channel partner should not misrepresent about you.
Understood, sir. वो तो I know, yeah.
कम से कम मिसरेप्रेजेंट नहीं करना चाहिए, आपका जो भी इन्फॉर्मेशन है वो सही सही बताना चाहिए.
इफ इनकेस अगर उन्हें कुछ पता नहीं है तो फिर उनको डायरेक्टली बोल देना चाहिए.
करेक्ट, सेल करने की उतनी जरूरत नहीं है, यू नो, कुछ भी बोल के सेल करो ऐसा तो नहीं.
राइट,
आई जस्ट सेंड इट टू यू, टेक अ लुक.
ओके, ठीक है, मैं वो कर लेती हूँ.
थैंक्स सो मच, बाय.